Meanwhile, residents who refused to leave one of the villages in the red zone have been recounting their experience. More in this report.
The action of this dog paints a bleak picture of the situation in Oya, which is one of the communities in the red zone on the windward side of the island, devastated by the eruption of La Sufrea volcano. The owner of the dog returned to the community for the first time on Sunday since the eruption started, and when it was time to leave, the dog jumped into the water and swam towards the boat.
We are taking it down, I'm taking it down. The dog just can't take the pressure up. Just can't take the pressure. Can look at the dog jump past it.
There is total destructive transformation of Oya, with a number of buildings destroyed, including churches, and the entire village covered with several inches of volcanic ash. New beaches were also formed, and a new waterfall developed from the destruction of the main bridge connecting Fancy to Oya. The riverbed of the Oya Big River has been totally transformed, with these huge boulders coming from the mountain slope. Dale Medica, who stayed behind, heard when it all happened.
It was like over about 1,000 yards away. I heard the rumbling, but I didn't make it here because rain was coming. Yeah, this is a new riverfall in Oya. This was born on the 13th of April, 2001.
Some areas in the community reeked of the scent of dead animals. This elderly resident, Grafton Caesar, is one of the men who did not evacuate. He said although they were able to save some animals, they could not save all.
When the river come down, sheep and goat and pigs wash into, when you watch goat and sheep inside the water, down in the seawater right there. Just like a wafted on the real sheep and goat and dogs, because they have no shelter place to shelter. So in the river, they have cave with the animal to go and shelter. But they don't know, because they don't have the opportunity like we human beings. So river take them and carry them away.
Another resident known as Jumbi said at this time, Oya is inhabitable as there is a constant sandstorm. He said it will take a long time before Oya returns to anything close to normal.
When you look at it, it's like it's a desert. We say you have to be good for living in a desert. The situation here we're going on now is a farming thing going on, And the people them cannot come back in this village here for now, because up at the water, situation real bad, real difficult now for put back pipe. Have to run real years before. Well, we can say, let me say plenty years, but it could take a time.
Due to the weight of volcanic ash, which has formed like cement, some roofs are caving in. The remaining Oya residents and those who have been watching videos and pictures of their houses from a distance are praying for rain to keep the dust down and wash away the dirt off their houses and crops, which for many are their livelihood. For SVG TV News, Larissa Pugsley.